Okay, we've got several film samples, some from Matico, some from Veloce, and these are films we're going to sample with the heat box, which is a box that has an incandescent infrared light bulb in it, and we have a baseline temperature, and we've got a heat probe, and the ambient temperature in the room is about 72 degrees. This is glass without any film covering on it. You can see the heat is rising. Infrared is part of the full light spectrum from the sun. All right, so in that small amount of time, it goes off with a timer. It rose to 74. Let's let this calm down a little bit. And then we're gonna put a sample of Matico Duralight 30. And the numbers basically mean the amount of visible light transmission. And this is 30% VLT, visible light transmission. Put that in, take a look at the temp. Trying to get the temp to come down. Okay, so it's dropping obviously. So let's put this on. And this is with the Duralight 30. Trying to convey the fact that when you can't feel what I'm feeling, but you can see there's a lot of energy that's not coming through. Let's try another film. This is the glare down, Veloce glare down 5. Blend, what they call blend 5. 5 meaning 5% of the light is being transmitted. Where are we with temperature? So. Beam on, bulb on. You really can't feel any heat coming through. Starting to drop. Yeah, so very good for energy. Here's another one. Here is Veloce Metallico Silver 15. 15 means 15% of the light transmitted through this film. Temperature 72. Of course, that's just, it's dropping because nothing's on. Bulb on, probe in front of. Screen time out. Again, you really can't feel any heat coming through. The probe is still at, 72. Very good. Heat shielding, and that's the infrared heat shielding. Now let's try Matico. This is the Nova 70, essentially clear. Right. give us three hands, okay? Because YouTube wasn't invented. Okay. All right, so bulb on, probe in front of, and still really can't feel any heat. These are good films. Okay, that went off. And the next film from Matico is going to be there. Optivision 45, which is a film that allows for 45% of the light coming through. I selected these for the energy efficiency, the total solar energy value. I mean, even though it's essentially very clear film, you're not getting a lot of heat coming through at all. Okay, so let's do a baseline and show what, again, the temperature was without any film. You can really feel the heat coming out of that thing. And you can see it rising. So with the films, with good quality film and a high TSER, T-S-E-R, total solar energy removed, you can get really good energy savings. And so what this is good for summer, it's also good for winter because these films reflect the heat. Now this is my Duralite 30 on my 8-foot Anderson sliders, which I showed demonstrations on earlier. And that reflects the heat back in the winter, which is really good for energy efficiency. Now let's take a look at, that's basically all I wanted to accomplish. I showed UVA and UVB. So the numbers you want to look at, and these two films manufacturers, I'm not advocating for either. However, I did a lot of research, and I'm a Matico dealer, Matico Sunscape, and Safety Shield preferred partner. So I love Matico. It's a U.S. manufactured film, good company, good reputation, long standing. There's an argument to be said that they've been the pioneers in window films, and Veloce. Which is a newcomer. However, I know the owner of Veloce, and he used to be International Window Film Association vice president for, I think, 15 years. Harry's a great guy. He knows exactly what he's after in terms of his films, so I'm going to take on his films essentially for the energy value, and the clarity is very good as well, and the support. The support's very good. These films are really, I mean, the ocular clarity is very good. Very good. And the numbers are good. Matter of fact, he has a film called Cool Touch, IR Cool Touch, that has the highest infrared shielding and TSER value. So in terms of window films, you want to look at form and function. This was my attempt at trying to explain in a layman's terms, light quality, the UV specifically, and what that is, UVA and UVB, temperature, and also the light emission, and I think I showed that through this probe earlier. All right, www.eclipsewindowfilmllc.com, and thank you very much for watching.